Today, I'm going to show you how to measure the wave period. The wave period is the distance between two waves passing through a stationary point. The wave period is measured in seconds. Now, why am I interested in this? When you see choppy waves with short wave periods of less than 10 seconds, these waves have most likely been generated somewhere else, far away, and have travelled across the ocean. In deep water, long period waves travel faster than short period waves. Therefore, when they reach shallow water, they slow down much faster than short period waves and break more powerfully, and are therefore of much more interest to surfers. First, we need to find a safe vantage point, and we also need a device for counting the waves. I can measure the wave period using either a stopwatch or an app on my phone. All you have to do is time 50 waves passing a fixed point and then calculate the average wave period. So first, we need to establish a fixed point in the water. Now, that could be like a jetty, a buoy, a boat, or even a rock in the water. Now, I'm going to use as my fixed point the rock you see over here at Mount Maunganui. Now, as soon as the next wave crest passes under that rock, I will count 50 wave crests and time it. So let's start counting. 1. 2. 3. 47. 48. 49. 50. Now that took 6 minutes and 1 second of timing. Later, you can calculate the wave period. 361 seconds divided by 50 wave crests equals 7.22. So that is a wave period of 7.22 seconds.